Good evening there, everybody. What is happening? Hopefully you all are having a wonderful day today. Oh boy. Anyways, man, so in recent news, unfortunate news, very unfortunate news, I actually released a prediction early this morning. I tried to get deep into depth about it, and I tried to break the fight down between Manny Pacquiao and Errol Spence Jr. because I realized just a couple of days ago that this fight was supposed to happen next week on August 21st. And then news today, which really came out of nowhere, at least for me, maybe I wasn't paying close attention enough, or maybe it just got released today, I'm not sure. But apparently Errol Spence Jr., apparently he has a torn retina in his eye, which of course forced the fight to get canceled. Now, if I wanted to push a narrative here, or I wanted to bash Errol Spence Jr., I could sit here and say, well, maybe this is just a strategy, maybe he got hurt in sparring, and overall maybe he's avoiding the fight. You know, I could do all the same stuff that basically the Deontay Wilder fans tried to do with Tyson Fury. And you never know what's going on behind the scenes. What I'm going to say is this. Do I believe that more than likely there was a torn retina? Do I believe more than likely that there was something up with his eye? I do possibly believe that. I do think that more than likely that is probably what happened. Errol Spence is a guy overall that has never really messed around with his career. This is a guy that pretty much has taken on every single challenge that has came his way. He took the challenge of Danny Garcia. He took the challenge of Kell Brook. He took the challenge of Sean Porter. I don't think Errol Spence is a guy that, in my opinion, is really afraid of anybody out there. I think that he is a man of very decent integrity, at least when it comes to his boxing career. He does have some problems outside the ring, but when it comes down to it overall, I do think that he's a very decent fighter, and I think that he's a very calculated, very logical type of fighter, and I think he's very highly skilled. It's very unfortunate now that this fight is going to be canceled. I'm really hoping that this fight does get resurrected, and overall that Manny Pacquiao, I believe Manny Pacquiao now, I believe that he's actually going to be facing Yordanis Ugas, the dangerous Cuban fighter, which is still going to be an interesting fight, because Yordanis Ugas, you know, even though he's not someone you would necessarily classify as an A-skilled boxer, maybe some of you disagree, he is someone that is still very dangerous. He has a lot of power. He has decent counter-punching ability. He can press forward very, very decently well. But I do think that his style is all wrong for Manny Pacquiao. Now, if Manny Pacquiao does underestimate Yordanis Ugas, he could find himself in a world of hurt. It's just very unfortunate because by the time this fight may happen, it may happen probably. I'm assuming now that this fight probably is going to happen in 2022. I'm not necessarily sure how long it takes to heal from a retina injury like this. This is not the first boxer who's had a retina injury. Of course, if you knew the all-time great Sugar Ray Leonard, he also had, you know, an issue with this, and I think he actually retired for a certain amount of time because of that. From what I looked up, and I'm not a doctor or anything like that, of course, but I seen that maybe it takes, you know, maybe about a month to heal from it. But I don't know how long the actual total healing process, and I'm not sure what the advice of the doctors are going to be. They may want him out for many months. They may want him out for a year. I'm not really sure how long it's going to be, but I do hope that this fight does happen sometime within the next year. It would be nice if we ended up getting the fight later on this year, but I just don't really see that happening. I mean, this fight was supposed to happen in August. You know, we do still have a certain amount more months. Maybe the fight can get end up in November or December. If it was going to happen this year, more than likely probably December. But it's very unfortunate. I don't see this fight happening now. This is a very big blow, unfortunate blow, because this was probably going to be, in my opinion, the biggest fight of the year, not just in boxing, probably in UFC. Conor McGregor versus Dustin Poirier, the trilogy, was a very big fight as well. And of course, Tyson Fury versus Deontay Wilder, when that fight, I do believe, will go down in October, when it comes down to it, that's going to be a very big fight. But I don't think that any of them would have been as big as Manny Pacquiao versus Errol Spence Jr. It's very unfortunate. We'll see what happens. If I had to guess, this fight is probably going to happen sometime now in 2022. I don't know necessarily when exactly, but it will be interesting to see what happens, you know, and when the fight will happen. I do hope that Manny Pacquiao does pull out of the fight. I'm not someone that usually pulls for favorites, I suppose. Well, I shouldn't say that, because I do have certain favorite fighters that I like to watch. I do have certain fighters that I do maybe cheer for and root for here and there, even though I wouldn't claim myself as a fanboy of any of them. But it's just very unfortunate to hear this news. And Manny Pacquiao and Errol Spence, it really was a perfect fight in my opinion, because I think both of them had certain advantages over the other and certain weaknesses that they could have really taken advantage of the other. So even though I had Errol Spence Jr. as a clear favorite, I still think that it was a hell of a fight. It was great to see Errol Spence come back very, very well. Man, I can't believe it. The last time he fought was in, I believe, November, December, sometime around there. He fought Danny Garcia last year in 2020, obviously, and he looked fantastic. We were all wondering how well he was going to come back from the car accident, and that's kind of some of the demons that I'm talking about. He apparently he does have a drinking problem outside the sport of boxing, and maybe some other issues as well. But he does seem like a decent person who's trying to improve his life when it comes down to it, and you know, get the best of his career. And this was going to be the biggest fight of his life, and it's just very unfortunate. And of course, for Manny Pacquiao as well, if you're a Manny Pacquiao fan, or if you're a person that loves to watch Manny Pacquiao fight, this would have been a fantastic fight to watch as well, to see if maybe he could have pulled off the upset. And you just wonder now if this fight is going to be completely ruined now, because Manny Pacquiao is 43 years old. If this fight happens next year, he's going to be even aging even more. So it's just, you know, you never know what's going to happen. And it kind of, this is very, very unfortunate, you know, when it comes down to it. But it is what it is. Things like these happen sometimes. You know, it is what it is. So good luck to Errol Spence Jr. I wish him the best recovery. A torn retina certainly is not something that you want to mess around with. That can make you blind in an eye. That's not something that you want to be permanent. I'm hoping that actually he comes out of this very, very okay. And I'm hoping that this isn't a situation where actually he has to be off for not even just a certain amount of many months, but maybe even years. Certain fighters, when they have a detached retina or a torn retina, that's not something that you want to mess around with. So we'll see what happens. I do believe more than likely that he certainly did have an eye injury. Errol Spence, I don't see a reason why he would, you know, try to get out of this fight. At least that's just my opinion on the situation. Errol Spence is a man overall to where I think that he takes on all comers. That's what I personally believe. And Errol Spence has always showed me he's one of the few boxers in the business to where he's shown me that he's very serious about taking on elite challengers. He's fought every elite challenger so far in his career. He's fought the great amount of them. He's fought Sean Porter. He had to trap Sean Porter in the corner. He had to trap Kell Brook in the corner. He finally got Danny Garcia when he became the main man of the division. And Mikey Garcia, he ended up getting, you know, that fight as well. So it's very unfortunate, but we'll see what happens. I wish the best of luck to Errol Spence Jr. Maybe I need to stop doing big fight predictions until literally a week before the fight, or maybe even a day before the fight, because this is the second big fight in a row to where I've done a fight prediction in boxing and it's gotten canceled. So we'll see what happens. I don't know. Maybe it's just some bad luck, but we'll see what happens, man. That's really all I got to say for today. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll talk to you all later. Let me know what you think of the news. Let me know overall, do you think this fight will happen later on this year? I'm guessing probably not. Or do you think that it's going to happen probably sometime next year? Do you think Errol Spence actually will return to the same form when it comes down to it? How long do you think this will put him out? Whatever you want to bring up. But when it comes down to it, that's really about it for today. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll talk to you all later. And I will probably put my Manny Pacquiao versus Jordanis Ugas prediction out there probably sometime next week, or maybe this week. It's going to be either this weekend or sometime next week. I may be a little bit busy this weekend, but we'll see what happens. I can put out a little video for that. Anyways, it'll be interesting, but let me know what y'all think. Anyways, that's about it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to y'all later.